Hello, English class. Welcome to our Chapter 6 reading in Narnia. Hola, clase de inglés. Bienvenidos a nuestro capítulo 6 en nuestra serie de lecturas. Vale, tenemos muchos anuncios hoy. Primeramente, yo quiero felicitar toda la clase y todos los participantes y del equipo y de los estudiantes incluso, porque hemos llegado a 100 vistas. We have arrived at 100 views on our... Thank you. Yes, we got 100 views on Chapter 5, and so that means, as I promised, we're going to have a special video coming shortly. Look out for that next week. Eso significa que vamos a tener un video especial y lo vas a ver llegando en la semana que viene. You're going to see that in next week. En la siguiente semana tendremos un video especial. Si recordéis, tenemos el regalo para esa cosa que... por la causa que hemos llegado a 100 vistas en nuestras lecturas, yo voy a tocar la flauta para vosotros en vivo, en directo, y eso va a ver en la siguiente semana. Vale, invita a tus amigos, diles que tendremos algo especial para todos en el YouTube. Y bueno, antes que nada, vamos a hablar de nuestros vídeos de preparar preparing for the reading. And if you remember, if you saw on Saturday, we had our first video, and like last week, we were not able to put out the second video, unfortunately. So that second video will come out tomorrow. Tenemos dos videos de prepararte para la lectura, preparing for the reading, para el capítulo 6. Y este video va a ver mañana, estoy un poco confundido. La segunda video va a salir mañana. So, tenemos ya en el YouTube, en nuestro canal, el video de spelling the E sound. So you can already go to our YouTube channel and look at that video, and it will help you tremendously if you haven't seen it yet. So si no has visto este video tratando de escribir el sonido E en inglés, yo te recomiendo que lo veas. Todos esos videos de preparar para la lectura, claro, son para esa lectura, capítulo 6. Pero cada video de preparar para la lectura puede aplicarse a cualquier lectura, cualquier conversación en inglés. Lo puedes aplicar en inglés. You can apply it to English in general. En general lo puedes aplicar. Por eso, no importa cuando lo veas, sino... Os recomiendo que lo veáis. Ok, creo que esos son todos los anuncios que tenemos hoy. Vamos a comenzar capítulo 6. We're going to start chapter 6. If you remember, we left off with all the children entering the wardrobe and entering Narnia. La última vez que dejamos a los niños en el capítulo 5, los dejamos entrando en el ropero y entrando en Narnia. Vamos a ver qué pasa ahora. Okay, let's go ahead and begin reading. As always, you can leave your comments in the live chat. Let's go ahead and begin. The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, Chapter 6, Into the Forest. I wish the MacCready would hurry up and take all these people away, said Susan presently. I'm getting horribly cramped. And what a filthy smell of camphor, said Edmund. I expect the pockets of these coats are full of it, said Susan, to keep away moths. There's something sticking into my back, said Peter. And isn't it cold, said Susan. Now that you mention it, it is cold, said Peter. And hang it all, it's wet too. What's the matter with this place? I'm sitting on something wet. It's getting wetter every minute. He struggled to his feet. Let's get out, said Edmund. They've gone. Oh, said Susan suddenly, and everyone asked her what was the matter. I'm sitting against a tree, said Susan,
And look, it's getting light over there.
By Jove, you're right, said Peter. And look there, and there, it's trees all around. And this wet stuff is snow. Why, I do believe we've got into Lucy's wood after all.
Y voy a hacer una pausa, solo para hacer una nota de esa frase, by Jove. Porque no es una frase bien común, de moderno, una frase moderna no es, es algo anticuada y algo británica, ¿no? Yo no sé exactamente si la gente del Reino Unido todavía usan esta frase, pero sí, si lo hacen, ahí lo vas a escuchar, pero no en los Estados Unidos. You will not hear this phrase in the United States, but it's good to know it. It's by Jove. That's a phrase to know. Something, of course, not in the United States, but in the United Kingdom, in England, you might hear it over there. All right. Also, before we continue on, antes que continuamos, yo quiero regresar al principio, porque la primera línea se trata de algo que estamos estudiando en los videos de preparar para la lectura. Entonces tenemos, I wish the MacReady would hurry up and take all these people away. Esa primera oración, esa primera cosa que dice Susan, es, ella está usando el subjuntivo. El subjuntivo, pasado, would. Would es el subjuntivo en el pasado, no en el presente, pero en el pasado. Pero la estructura de esa oración, the structure of this sentence, starts with the phrase, I wish, o en español, yo deseo. I wish es en el presente, y está seguido por un sujeto, the MacReady, but in case you don't know, the children use the MacReady as a way of joking about this lady, whose name is Mrs. MacReady. Su nombre en realidad es Señora MacReady, pero los niños le llaman la MacReady, the MacReady, solo para hacer una broma, los niños. Y vale, está seguido el sujeto, the MacReady, by would hurry up. Would, as we learn in our video that's going to come out tomorrow, como aprendemos en el video que va a publicar mañana, would es, se llama en inglés modal word, it is a modal word, or una palabra auxiliaria, y está usado para poner perdón, nos cortó el audio, perdón, otra vez, estamos aquí en By Jove, You're Right, so let's pick up from there.
By Jove, you're right, said Peter, and look there, and there, it's trees all round, and this wet stuff is snow. Why, I do believe we've got into Lucy's wood after all.
Y si te recuerdas, we've... es una contracción de dos palabras, we've, ¿no? Es we have. En español yo diría hemos, nosotros hemos. Y got into, entrar dentro, ¿ok? Got into. La palabra got en inglés, G-O-T, tiene varias tiene varios usos y definiciones. En ese caso, en español, bueno, en México dirían agarrar, o en Cuba y otras partes dirían coger, pero en este caso no se ha usado así. Se ha usado como entrar, ¿ok? Entrar. Entonces, got into. Cuando tienes got y una preposición así, got into, está usado como entrar, ¿vale? Vale, vamos a continuar.
Why, I do believe we've got into Lucy's wood after all. And now there was no mistaking it. And all four children stood blinking in the daylight of a winter day.
Behind them were coats hanging on pegs. In front of them were snow-covered trees. Peter turned at once to Lucy. "I apologize for not believing you," he said. "I'm sorry. Will you shake hands?"
"Of course," said Lucy, and did.
"And now," said Susan, "what do we do next?"
"Do?" said Peter.
"Why, go and explore the wood, of course."
"Ah," said Susan, stamping her feet. "It's pretty cold. What about putting on some of these coats?"
"They're not ours," said Peter, doubtfully.
"I am sure nobody would mind," said Susan. "It isn't as if we wanted to take them out of the wood. We shan't take them even out of the wardrobe."
"I never thought of that, Sue," said Peter. "Of course, now you put it that way, I see. No one could say you had bagged a coat as long as you leave it in the wardrobe where you found it. And I suppose the whole country is in the wardrobe." They immediately carried out Susan's very sensible plan. The coats were rather too big for them, so that they came down to their heels and looked more like royal robes than coats when they had put them on. But they all felt a good deal warmer, and each thought the others looked better in their new get-ups and more suitable to the landscape. "We can pretend that we are Arctic explorers," said Lucy.
"This is going to be exciting enough without pretending."
Y claro, si te recuerdas del último video que hicimos en el capítulo 5, encontramos en ese video, la palabra pretend. Y claro que, como hicimos claro en el último capítulo, pretend no tiene el mismo significado que en español. En español tenemos la palabra pretenderse o pretender, no significa igual. Es como podemos decir, digamos, un falso amigo, un amigo falso, porque se parece muy similar. Y no tengo que explicar todo eso otra vez, ya lo expliqué en el último video, en el último capítulo. Regresa ahí si quieres pillar una explicación más completa. Vamos a continuar leyendo a continuación. Lucy dice,
"We can pretend we are Arctic explorers," said Lucy.
"This is going to be exciting enough without pretending," said Peter, as he began leading the way forward into the forest. There were heavy, darkish clouds overhead, and it looked as if there might be snow before night.
Tenemos un comentario de nuestra hermana Vanessa Hernández diciendo que será fingir es la definición correcta de pretend, y es correcto lo que dice la hermana. Gracias, hermana. Y hablamos eso en el capítulo 5 y hicimos esa distinción entre pretender, fingir, y pretend and to try, right? Porque pretender, si quieres decir esa palabra en inglés, sería mejor traducido como to try, to intend, intend or to try, básicamente. Okay, continuamos aquí.
There were heavy, darkish clouds overhead, and it looked as if there might be more snow before night.
Y si tú ves, tenemos un otro modal word. It's another modal word. So keep that in mind. Mantén esa palabra en mente para el video de subjuntivos que va a salir, como dije, mañana. Okay.
"I say," said Edmund presently, "oughtn't..."
Otra palabra modal. It's another modal word. Solo yo quiero subrayar todos ellos porque mañana se va a tratar de esas palabras.
"Oughtn't we to be bearing a bit more to the left? That is, if we are aiming for the lamp post." He had forgotten for the moment that he must pretend never to have been in the wood before. The moment the words were out of his mouth, he realized that he had given himself away. Everyone stopped. Everyone stared at him. Peter whistled.
Y si quieres saber, la palabra realized, podemos decir, es una otra perdón, otro falso amigo, amigo falso, porque realizar no tiene el mismo significado en inglés. Realize es más como darse cuenta que realizar. Realizar tiene un sentido diferente. Realizar es como en inglés, yo no sé exactamente qué diría el diccionario, pero creo que el diccionario diría, la traducción sería como perform or to make happen in that way, like perform something, like when you are doing a play, you say, cuando hagas una obra teátrica, dicen realizar la obra, y eso es lo que significa realizar. Realize, en inglés, escrito muy similar y semejante, no significa eso, solo para que sepáis otra vez. Déjanos continuar. Peter whistled. "So you really were here," he said. "That time, Lou said she'd met you in here and you made out she was telling lies." There was a dead silence. "Well, all of the poisonous little beasts," said Peter, and shrugged his shoulders and said no more. There seemed, indeed, no more to say, and presently the four resumed their journey. But Edmund was saying to himself, "I'll pay you all out for this, you pack of stuck-up, self-satisfied prigs." "Where are we going, anyway?" said Susan, chiefly for the sake of changing the subject. "I think Lou ought to be the leader," said Peter. "Goodness knows she deserves it. Where will you take us, Lou?" "What about going to see Mr. Tumnus?" said Peter. "He's the nice fawn I told you about." Everyone agreed to this, and off they went, walking briskly and stamping their feet. Lucy proved a good leader. At first, she wondered whether she would be able to find the way, but she recognized an odd-looking tree on one place and a stump in another, and brought them on to where the ground became uneven and into the little valley, and at last to the very door of Mr. Tumnus's cave. But there, a terrible surprise awaited them. The door had been wrenched off its hinges and broken to bits. Inside, the cave was dark and cold and had the damp feel and smell of a place that had not been lived in for several days. Snow had drifted in from the doorway and was heaped on the floor, mixed with something black, which turned out to be charred sticks and ashes from the fire. Someone had apparently flung it about the room and then stamped it out. The crockery lay smashed on the floor, and the picture of the fawn's father had been slashed into shreds with a knife. "This is a pretty good washout," said Edmund. "Not much good coming here." "What is this?" said Peter, stooping down. He had just noticed a piece of paper which had been nailed through the carpet of the floor. "Is there anything written on it?" asked Susan. "Yes, I think there is," answered Peter. "But I can't read it in this light. Let's get out into the open air." They all went out in the daylight and crowded round Peter as he read out the following words. Y en este momento es un perfecto momento para hacer una nota de diferencia entre dos palabras. Si visteis, el vídeo de sábado, que se trata de ortografía inglesa, habla de una palabra particular. Habla de la palabra read, R-E-A-D. Y yo, como explicaba en el video, read can be pronounced differently, even though it is written the same, okay? La palabra read, o en español leer, puede ser pronunciado diferentemente dependiente en el contexto, okay? Se depende en cómo lo usamos. Si lo usamos en el presente, significando como en este caso tenemos, "but I can't read," no puedo leer, okay? "I can't read," this is in the infinitive, either way, but we have it here, right? Leer, right? if we use it here, we're implying that it's in the infinitive, or we're implying it's in the present, okay?
Pero podemos decir que... Okay, perdón, déjame traducir lo que acabo de decir.
Estamos implicando, por leer read con un sonido E, read, estamos diciendo, o implicando, que la oración está en el presente o infinitivo. Y en ese caso ya podemos ver que es el infinitivo porque esa sigue un verbo. I can't or cannot read it. Okay? No lo puedo leer. No, es aquí. Si lo queremos traducir exactamente y subrayar dónde están las palabras, dónde estarían las palabras en español. Okay. No or not, right? No puedo, no, perdón. No puedo leer lo, o no lo, no lo puedo leer, ¿ok? All right, solo hago eso para decir que read is here in a very specific context. La palabra read está en un contexto muy específico, ¿ok? Y en el siguiente paráfrafo encontramos la palabra, la misma palabra, pero pronunciado diferentemente. Leamos esa oración otra vez. They all went out in the daylight and crowded round Peter as he read out the following words. Okay? Okay. As he read out the following words. As he read out. Okay. Lo que está pasando aquí. El tiempo, the tense, el tiempo, el tiempo de donde se ocurre, no cambia. Lo que cambia es que tenemos esa preposición. Esa preposición y añadida con la palabra read cambia, es diferente ahora. Es una otra palabra, está diciendo algo específico. Read out solo es como su propio verbo, porque está diciendo read out, leer en voz alta, podemos decir. Por eso... Oh, no, perdón. Okay. Eso existe. Eso es la verdad. Pero también es por causa de que está en el pasado. Y eso es más importante. Cuando esté en el pasado, read cambia a ser read. As he read the following words. Mientras leía, en español, leía en el pasado... las palabras siguientes, ¿ok? So, si regresas al video de ortografía y el sonido I en inglés que publicó el sábado, vas a encontrar esa explicación otra vez, ¿ok? La diferencia cuando digas read en cuando digas read, ¿ok? Ok, vale, vamos a continuar. The former occupant of these premises, the Fawn Tomness, is under arrest and awaiting his trial on a charge of high treason against Her Imperial Majesty Jadis, Queen of Narnia, Chatelaine of Caer Paravel, Empress of the Lone Islands, etc. Also of comforting her said Majesty's enemies, harboring spies, and fraternizing with humans. Signed, Mogrim, Captain of the Secret Police. Long live the Queen. Y long live the Queen, o larga viva la reina, es un buen ejemplo de subjuntivo, porque es una declaración de deseo, no una declaración de hecho o de cómo lo puedo decir, no es una declaración actual, como no le estoy diciendo algo está pasando actualmente o algo es la verdad actualmente. Lo que estoy diciendo es que yo quiero que la reina viva, ¿no? Viva la reina. Quiero que la reina viva, yo puedo decir. Long live the queen. I wish that the queen live. Okay? Long. I wish that the queen live. This is a way of... We use it in English, just like we use in Spanish, you know, viva el rey, o viva la reina en español. Es en el subjuntivo, porque no estamos declarando un hecho, algo que es actual, ¿me entiende? Es algo que queremos que pase, ¿ok? Long live the queen. Eso es el subjuntivo. Y es un ejemplo de subjuntivo bien, bien claro en el inglés, ¿ok? Cuando encuentres subjuntivo, a ver, en esa forma, más o menos, porque es bien común. Bien común. Es un uso bien, bien común del subjuntivo en inglés, ¿ok? Continuemos. The children stared at each other. I don't know that I'm going to like this place after all, said Susan. Who is this Queen Lou? Said Peter. Do you know anything about her? She isn't a real queen at all, answered Lucy. She's a horrible witch, the White Witch. Everyone, all the wood people, hate her. She has made an enchantment over the whole country, so that it is always winter here, and never Christmas. I wonder if there's any point in going on, said Susan. I mean, it doesn't seem particularly safe here, and it looks as if it won't be much fun either. And it's getting colder every minute, and we've brought nothing to eat. What about just going home? Oh, but we can't, said Lucy suddenly. Don't you see? We can't just go home, not after this. It is all on my account that the poor fawn has got into this trouble. He hid me from the witch and showed me the way back. That's what it means by comforting the queen's enemies and fraternizing with humans. We simply must try to rescue him. A lot we could do, said Edmund, when we haven't even got anything to eat. Shut up, you, said Peter, who was still very angry with Edmund. What do you think, Susan? I've a horrid feeling that Lou is right, said Susan. I don't want to go a step further, and I wish we'd never come. Y quiero repetir esa última parte, porque es otra vez el subjuntivo en el pasado, ¿ok? Y yo voy a... el problema es que la parte que está en el subjuntivo es un poco escondido, porque lo encontramos aquí en una otra contracción, que, claro, como ya has leído, bien, bien común en inglés, queremos... nos gusta contractar nuestras palabras, ¿ok? Para ser más fluido, podemos decir. All right. I wish we had never come, ¿ok? Eso es una declaración de deseo, claro, porque usamos wish, I wish, o yo deseo. I wish we'd never come. Y claro, mañana vas a ver un video más hablando y explicando en mucho detalle el subjuntivo. Por eso, puedes esperar hasta mañana para tener mucho detalle y no voy a tener la historia más porque quiero continuar con la historia y no quiero hacer demasiada interrupción. Ok. Continuando. But I think we must try to do something for Mr. Whatever his name is. I mean the fawn. That's what I feel too, said Peter. I'm worried about having no food with us. I'd vote for going back and getting something from the larder. Y esta palabra larder es una expresión o una palabra para es como es en la cocina, ¿no? Okay, yeah. Yo no estoy bien seguro, pero es en la cocina. Yo sé, it's in the kitchen, the larder. Okay, or it's like the pantry, I believe in English. We say the pantry, la cocina o la bodega de la cocina, podemos decir. Okay. A veces no hay palabras exactas para traducir, pero podemos encontrar una palabra acerca, ¿ok? O cercana. Ok, continuamos, vale.
Only there doesn't seem to be any certainty of getting into this country again when once you've got out of it. I think we'll have to go on. So do I, said both the girls. If only we knew where the poor chap was imprisoned.
Lo repito.
If only we knew where the poor chap was imprisoned.
Subjuntivo. Otra vez. Okay. Continuamos.
Said Peter. They were all still wondering what to do next when Lucy said, Look, there's a robin with such a red breast. It's the first bird I've seen here. I say, I wonder, can birds talk in Narnia? It almost looks as if it wanted to say something to us. Then she turned to the robin and said, please, can you tell us where Thomas and the fawn has been taken to? Sorry, Loleiman. Can you tell us where Thomas the fawn has been taken to? As she said this, she took a step toward the bird. It at once flew away.
Oh, y tenemos la traducción. Gracias, hermana Vanessa. Larger is despensa. Despensa. Ok. Vale, vale, vale. Gracias, hermana. All right, continuemos. ¿Dónde estuve?
All right. Then she turned to the robin and said, please, can you tell us where Thomas the fawn has been taken to? As she said this, she took a step toward the bird. It at once flew away, but only as far as to the next tree. There it perched and looked at them very hard, as if it understood all they had been saying. Almost without noticing that they had done so, the four children went a step or two nearer to it. At this, the robin flew away again to the next tree and once more looked at them very hard. You couldn't have found a robin with a redder chest or a brighter eye. Do you know, said Lucy, I really believe he means us to follow him. I've an idea he does, said Susan. What do you think, Peter? Well, we might as well try it, answered Peter. The robin appeared to understand the matter thoroughly. He kept going from tree to tree, always a few yards ahead of them, but always so near that they could easily follow it. In this way, it led them on, slightly downhill. Slightly downhill. Wherever the robin alighted, a little shower of snow would fall off the branch. Presently, the clouds parted overhead, and the winter sun came out, and the snow all around them grew dazzlingly bright. They had been traveling in this way for about half an hour, with the two girls in front, when Edmund said to Peter, if you're not still too high and mighty to talk to me, I've something to say, which you'd better listen to. What is it? Asked Peter. Hush, not so loud, said Edmund. There's no good frightening the girls. But have you realized what we're doing? What? Said Peter, lowering his voice to a whisper. We followed a guide we know nothing about. How do we know which side that bird is on? Why shouldn't it be leading us into a trap?
Ah, y tenemos aquí. No es una forma de subjuntivo esta última oración. Why shouldn't it be leading us into a trap? Pero es acerca del mismo concepto, ¿no? Porque es una proclamación de como no estás hablando de lo actual, pero estás hablando de lo posible, ¿ok? Y como dije, mañana te animo que veáis este video, ¿ok? Acerca de subjuntivo, ¿ok? Otra vez. Why shouldn't it be leading us into a trap? That's a nasty idea. Still, a robin, you know, they're good birds. In all the stories I've ever read, I'm sure a robin wouldn't be on the wrong side. If it comes to that, which is the right side? How do we know that the fawns are in the right and the queen, yes, I know we've been told she's a witch, is in the wrong? We don't really know anything about either. The fawn saved Lucy. He said he did, but how do we know? And there's another thing, too. Has anyone the least idea of the way home from here? Great Scott, said Peter. I hadn't thought of that. And no chance of dinner either, said Edmund.
Okay, vale. Hemos llegado al fin de esta lectura. We have arrived at the end of the reading. Thanks for sticking with us. I know we had some glitches today, some audio problems, and other little problems. Understand that I am doing this by myself right now, so we don't have a second person. But we are trying to get better, so hopefully next time we'll minimize the problems. Again, let us know your comments and if you have suggestions. En español, yo voy a decir. Solo que yo decía en inglés que lo siento por unos problemillas que tuvimos hoy en la lectura. Es que había problemas con el audio y otras cosas. Y tenemos y nuestro equipo está limitado hoy. Pero ojalá la semana que viene vamos a tener más. Eso es todo que tenemos. Un último anuncio, si no escuchaste en el principio, la siguiente lectura tendremos, antes de la lectura, algo tremendo, especial y bien, bien divertido para vosotros. Una presentación yo voy a realizar en la flauta, una canción de la película de Narnia, El León, la Bruja y el Ropero, en la flauta, en vivo, antes de la lectura. Esta es en celebración y felicitación de porque hemos logrado 100 vistas, como expliqué antes. Llegamos a 100 vistas en el último capítulo y todos estamos muy emocionados por eso, porque estamos creciendo y estamos siguiendo adelante. Y vale, eso es todo. Gracias otra vez por acompañarnos. Como dije, yo decía en inglés que me mandéis los comentarios que tenéis. Y me enviéis por correo electrónico, por comentarios en YouTube, tus sugerencias, tus preguntas, lo que sea. Yo quiero escuchar de vosotros. Eso es todo. I want to hear from you all. Again, this is the Potter's House Christian Church here in San Jose, California, a Pentecostal church. And I'm going to say good night, and I shall see you next week. Have a fond farewell.